Central Park Reservoir.
The water system.
Pumping goo everywhere.
Adding more and more people to the hive mind.
If all those symbiotes get out of Manhattan...
Goodbye, Earth. Hello, planet goo. The meteorite is the source of all the power, right? Creating goo, creating symbiotes. But it was useless until Harry repaired it.
Yeah.
And that particle accelerator is what damaged it in the first place. Cut off a piece at low power.
Right, so what if we crank the power up? Like way past 11?
Might destroy it.
And free everyone connected to the hive mind.
Theoretically.
But that reservoir's gotta be mobbed with symbiotes. And you know Harry's not gonna let that rock out of his sight.
Unless he sees something he wants more. Me. Just, you know, for illustrative purposes. Harry's still Harry. He thinks he's healing the world. But the dream isn't complete without...
his best friend beside him.
I can lead Harry away from the meteorite.
And I can handle all the symbiotes.
While I grab the space rock. For illustrative purposes.
All right. Fire up the accelerator. No more hive mind. World saved. We all get churros?
Theoretically.
Pete, what Connor said about Harry being too far gone. If you can't save him, are you
ready? It won't come to that. You two will be able to destroy the rock in time. Let's heal the world.
For real this time. Somewhere in that thing?
So are Harry and his friends.
Here. I figured you could use a sonic touch.
They're just standing there. What are they waiting for?
Look. I can't thank you both enough. For everything.
Come on, bro. We're the spider team.
Don't anyone forget it.
Hey, buddy! You gonna sit in there and play with your pet rock all night? You and me, Harry. Like we always wanted.
Our gift will finally be yours.
Here's the thing, though. You're gonna have to catch me first.
Story, Watson. What was that? Dead end? No. Whoever dropped these flares, I hope they made it out. Ugh. sent a team after Harry. I guess they left more than just players behind. Those barrels look wired to blow.
Not good, not good. Meteorites connected to the rest of the hive. Just a normal rock. That can also end the world. My exit's just past that chopper.
Thank you.
can't go for the ladder with this thing still on me. Hey, I think that hurt it.
Sure, your plus one isn't invited to our high school reunion, Harry! Harry!
Chance, Pete!
giving me a choice!
Whoa, symbiote's dropping in.
Stay calm! Take him out one at a time!
Down. doesn't matter what you do to me. I'm never gonna heal the world with you. Not like this.
The meteorite. You took it from us.
Kick your ass!
doesn't need you anymore. He hears us now.
Go, Miles! finish this?
Almost.
We still have time.
No, we don't. It'll kill them. And then it'll kill you. Let's heal the world, Pete. Together.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Give me some room. I don't know if it's gonna work, but I gotta try.
Pulse is weak. We gotta move.
What have you done?
What have you done to him?
I'm so sorry.
I'm coming with you. Wait.
There are traces of brain activity, but his chances of coming back are very slim.
Just keep him alive. Get the G-Serum ready. ASAP.
For the last few years, tragedy has tried to tear the city apart. But we somehow kept going. We battled sickness, evil, cataclysm. We are tired, anxious, stressed, numb. But we have never lost hope. The city needs to heal. We're all ready to return to normal, but what is normal? What if it no longer exists? Over the last half hour, I've talked about how these events have changed me. But what about you? In this ongoing series, I will be talking with people throughout the city, exploring our new behaviors, new routines, new thoughts and feelings, I hope you'll join me on this journey. This has been Mary Jane Watson, and you're listening to The New Normal. Episode one, done.
Nice.
I don't know.
Ooh, are these good to go?
In a minute, I want to show you something first.
Okay.
It has molasses in it.
Yum, I'll take those.
Thanks again for the donation, Peter. Have you talked to Miles about?
Not yet.
You ready?
Miles. I've been meaning to talk to you about something. I have been talking to you all the time. It's great to talk. So many good talks. I just haven't been talking to you about what I should have been talking to you about.
Pete.
Let me start again.
I got this. All of it. Go be Peter Parker for a while.
Are you sure? It's a big city.
I can handle it. As long as I can still call you for advice.
You don't need it.
Maybe not now, but there'll come a time.
I'm here for you. Always.
Big bro. See you.
What do you want?
The Spider-Men. You know who they are, don't you?
Why?
They ruined my son.
We all have to experience loss. Even you, Norman.
What are you writing?
The final chapter.
Hi. I hope you're hungry. Food's almost ready. Why don't you go show her your essay? He worked so hard on it.
Some guy in Harlem, probably seen him volunteering in the city, helping out his city council mom, and trying to live up to his hero dad. Yeah.
Hi. Miles, Haley, this is Albert.
Hi. Nice to meet you. Oh, and this is my daughter, Cindy.
What's up, New York?
MJ!
Hey! Just wanted to let you know you got a package here at the house.
Okay.
I put it in the garage for you. It's from Norman Osborn.
Oh, interesting. Thanks for letting me know. Break time's over.
What's this? Lance and a thumb drive? They say you should never plug in a drive of unknown origin. But I know Norman, I think.
Peter! I put this together for you because I knew when we got through this crazy time, whenever we got through it, I wanted you to have these. And I wasn't positive I'd be here to give them to you myself.
Harry.
After the Emily May Foundation was destroyed by Kraven's hunters. I went to see what I could recover before it got boarded up. In the box, you'll find a piece of bark from my mom's tree, and one of May's blossoms. And I thought, if you gene splice them together, you might get a hardy enough plant to produce seeds.
Wow. Well, okay.
Drones we salvaged from the field studies? We just leveraged their relocation data sets to plant those seeds around the city.
You're some kind of genius, Harry Osborn. Let's get those bees working.
I know. It'll be years before we see the results. And who's to say where you and I will be a week from now, let alone years from now? Which is why I did this simulation to show you. So Emily and May will live on in the city, and of course, in us. I love you, Pete. I really do. And I know the Foundation didn't end up going the way I'd hoped, but there's still no one I'd rather have tried it with. I bet by the time you get this, we'll have already started a new Foundation. Just me and you. From scratch. Go us.
Go us.
Oh! One last thing. I got a little something for you. We're in good health. Love you.